It's Saturday night, and we're about to discover who's got stars in their eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Matthew Kelly.
Welcome to Stars in Their Eyes. Nobody wants to say it, but this is the last show in the series. In just 45 minutes, the studio doors will be unlocked for the first time in 12 weeks, and the audience will be allowed to go home. I'll miss them, but ooh, it's been worth it. And next week, it's the live final, our all-winner show, when you, the loyal viewer, will be able to phone in and vote for your favourite. That's going to be a big event for all concerned, but right now, this is the show that's the big event, especially for our five star guests. So let's meet star guest number one.
My name is Louis Stevens. I'm 29 years of age, used to live in Surrey, and now live in south of Spain, Seville. I used to fix photocopiers and now run my own business in the field service engineering. I like living in Spain because it's got such a relaxed atmosphere. You're really laid back. You live life to the full. If you can't get the job done, then it's mañana, tomorrow. I do like singing. When I first met my wife, I thought that it would be a nice thing to do is to serenade her with the song I'm going to be singing tonight. The most important thing for me right now is to appear on the show and to have 5 minutes of stardom. If something comes of it, then fine. If not, then I have this memory to take away with me.
Memories are made of this. Please welcome Louis Stevens. So, first of all, we've got to clear something up. You've moved to Spain, although you're an English boy, but you're born of Spanish parents who came to this country.
Yes, yes.
Will you just explain to me how they came to come to be in this country?
Funny story, actually. Father, with his brothers, got a hat, three pieces of paper, Australia, America, England, pulled one out of the hat, and England...
And it was England?
Yep.
Yes, and then you've gone back to Spain as well.
Yes, yes.
Why did you do that?
Well, I was fed up with the rat race, you know, working in London and everything, and saw the opportunity to just snap up and...
So give us a typical day in Spain.
Well, a typical day in Spain is sun all day round, you're more relaxed, laid back, you know, and as I said in the film, if you can't get things done, then mañana.
And what about, do you live near the sea?
Yes, I've got a house in the shallow beach, 500 yards from the sea.
You see, and, I mean...
Just live life to the full.
But it's easy for you to say. The rest of us want that, don't we?
Well, I mean, it's just a question of getting up and going.
Yeah, it's always mañana, though, isn't it, really?
Oh, that's right. You know.
You have a very interesting ambition if you win the lottery.
Yes, if I ever win the lottery, I will hire out the Royal Albert Hall, full-blown orchestra, and everyone's invited, just free tickets all around.
All of us?
Yep.
I think we'll take that up, won't we? I'll be the first in the line, mate, don't you worry.
Including
myself. Tell me how you got into the person that you're going to be, because he is quite sort of old-fashioned in a way, isn't he?
Yes, via my mother. Ever since I was 9 years old, just listening to the records, fell in love with his voice. Superb, yes.
Your mum's favourite. Tell us who you're going to be.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Matt Munro.
Matt Munro, born to be free. An exact copy of the original tonight, singing live, Louis Stevens is Matt Munro.
See a portrait never seen. Anyone who sees her soon forgets the Mona Lisa. It would take, I know, a Michelangelo, and he would need the glow of dawn that paints the sky above to try and paint a portrait of my love. It would take, I know, a Michelangelo, and he would need the glow of dawn that paints the sky above to try and paint a portrait.
I'll tell you something, I don't really think you need to win the lottery to get to the Albert Hall with a voice like that.
Thank you very much.
It's fantastic. Yeah, right. It's your mum there. Ladies and gentlemen, Louis Stevens as Matt Monro. Matt Monro with a portrait of my love. Now here's a thumbnail sketch of star guest number two.
My name's Kevin Metcalf. I'm 25 years old. At the moment, I'm unemployed. My girlfriend's name's Nicola. I have a little daughter that's 4 months old. Her name's Shannon. And she's basically gorgeous. Wigan people are good, nice and friendly. They've always got something to say, always happy. Wigan's famous for three things: Wigan rugby, pies, and it's casino days when they used to have Northern Soul nights. When they told me that I got to the second auditions, then I thought, oh, this could be it. It was over the moon.
Over the moon and onto the stage comes Kevin Metcalf. You said there were three things that Wigan was famous for. What about the pier?
Well, it's not much of a pier, really. It's more of a jetty. It's about 3 foot long. It's nice at the side of a canal.
Is that Wigan's little joke on the world, is it?
Yeah.
You're no stranger to entertainment, are you? Because you've topped the bill with somebody very well known.
Yeah, that's right. When I was about 15 years old, I was doing breakdancing for charity in a nightclub in Wigan. And we topped the bill with Tony Christie, but at the time I didn't know who he was.
Well, you wouldn't do it at 15, would you? Now, you mentioned Northern Soul. Do you remember the Northern Soul at the Wigan Casino?
I was about 7 years old, I think, when they pulled the casino down. I like all the singers from that era, like Edwin Starr and Al Wilson's and all them.
Would you consider the man that you're going to be a soul singer?
Probably. He's a mixed variety of music. He writes a lot of ballads. Basically sings about his girlfriend leaving him.
Bit of a cheerful soul, then.
Yeah.
Would you consider that you look like the person that you're going to be?
Once I've been done up, yeah. A little bit.
Well, you do have the hair, really, don't you?
Yeah.
But the guy has had his hair cut off, but you're going to stay as he was then.
Yeah, from the song that he sang.
Tell us who you're going to be, Kevin.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Curtis Stigers.
Curtis Stigers! The raunchy American rocker! Famous for rugby pies, and tonight, singing live, Kevin Metcalf is Curtis Stigers!
I'm
make mistakes like any man. But I try to love you the best I can. I can't convince you, though heaven knows I try. I've tried to make you see, to make you believe you're all that matters to me. The ground that you walk, the air that you breathe. Someday you'll discover I don't want no other. Believe me, you're all that matters, baby. Looking for paradise, baby, I know that I've found mine. Oh. And if you don't believe it, baby, take a look at the love in my eyes. Oh, I'll be with you, baby, till the end of time. You'll be alright, baby.
Honestly, you look great. You make it look easy. And you love it, don't you?
I do. Yes, I do.
You can tell. Well, you can forget the pier. This is the most famous thing about Wigan. Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Metcalf as Curtis Stigers. The rock-solid rhythm of Curtis Stigers and now someone else who never misses a beat. Star guest number three.
My name's Richard Vernon. I'm 27 years old. I was born in Rotherham, South Yorkshire, and I now live in Doncaster. I've been a police constable for 8 years now.
Hello there, can I help you?
My height's quite a big advantage. I'm 6 foot four, just over. Whenever we go out to a job, I'm not usually the one that gets picked on. I was told that Matthew Kelly's about 6 foot four, 6 foot five, so we should get on quite well, really, because we should be eye to eye.
Yeah, that appears to be
in relation to the person I'm going to be tonight, it started really because I was just on my way home from work one day and had a compilation tape on, and this person came on singing a song which is famous for, and I sang along to it and thought I sound a little bit like him. I've always wanted to apply for Stars in Their Eyes, so I thought I'll give it a go as this person. Coming through the doors is the big thing for me onto that set. I'm really looking forward to it.
Top of the bill tonight, Richard Vernon.
Here you are, tall, aren't you?
Yeah. isn't it handy being tall?
Very handy.
Because you don't see eye to eye with your wife, Gillian, do you really?
No, not very really.
Why is that?
Because she's only 5'3" tall.
But that's not the only reason that you don't see eye to eye with her.
No. To be quite honest, my wife, Gillian, hates the song that I'm going to do tonight.
Has that been tricky when you've been trying to rehearse it?
Not really. There's one added complication as to why she don't like the song.
Why is that?
Because I've got a 3-year-old son, Michael, who now knows all the words to the song, and whenever I sing it, he sings along too.
Nice one, Michael, very good. The people who work in police stations, I'm sure, are merciless about their fellow officers appearing on a show like this.
Just a little, yeah.
And have they done anything evil to you?
Now and again, I can go to work on odd occasion, and as I walk around lockers, somebody will jump out of one and start going to full song. The song I'm going to be doing tonight.
Tell us a bit about the person that you're going to be.
The person I'm going to be tonight, Matthew, we had a big hit in 1980 in the Eurovision Song Contest, and then went on to have another hit in 1987, I believe.
In fact, he won twice, and he was Irish. Tell us who you're going to be.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Johnny Logan.
Johnny Logan, the man with double Eurovision. He's walking tall because tonight, singing live, Richard Burden is Johnny Logan.
But you're not me. What's another year? I've been waking such a long time, reaching out for you, but you aren't me. What's another year?
Fantastic. I defy your mates to take the mickey out of that voice. It was brilliant.
Thank you.
Mind you, can you believe people dressed like that in 1980? Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Burden as Johnny Logan. You know, if this was the Eurovision Song Contest, you'd have another 25 songs to endure. I'd be Katie Boyle and there'd be no commercial break, so think on and look sharp. I'll see you in a bit.
Once upon a time, a little prince called Robbie was sad because his parents kept arguing. The Queen just cared about pink and fluffy things, so she wanted luxury, soft toilet paper. The King, who was deeply into nature, used rough toilet paper, which wasn't so friendly, on the old bottle. One day, Prince Robbie was so depressed, he wandered around the kingdom looking for a solution. Until a beautiful fairy, dressed as a shop assistant, showed him new quilted Nouvelle, the toilet paper that is both luxury and recycled. Thanks to Nouvelle, the king and queen never had another domestic. Well, nearly.
Aerosols can leave white marks. Roll-ons can be sticky. But Shaw's extraordinary new ultra-dry cream goes on dry and vanishes in to give you the ultimate dryness protection. Better than the leading aerosol or roll-on. So it keeps on keeping you dry. New Shaw ultra-dry cream. Nothing out there keeps you drier.
Get straight to the point. Auto windscreens. Auto windscreens. You get straight to the point, we'll get straight to the problem.
If you're going to travel, travel light. Toffee crisp. Chocolate. Caramel. And a light crispy centre. Which won't slow you down.
Welcome back to Stars in Their Eyes. They've been going mad in here while you've been away. The audience want to stay another week and see the live final. I've told them no. I mean, it's not just the band that are humming in here. So if they can go and pop on a clean party frock, they can stay, but not before we've all seen star guest number four.
Come on, Sam, darling, time to
My name is Catherine
boy.
Clayton, I'm 35 years old, and I'm from Barrington, Cumbria.
Time to put up for school, good girl.
Right. I've been married to Steve for 14 years, and we've got three children. Steve works away from home. I used to be an auxiliary nurse. But with him working away, I've just stayed at home looking after the children. It takes a lot of my time up. I first learnt I could sing when I went into my local pub just round the corner with my husband and a few friends, and the karaoke was on. I just picked the particular song that I'm singing tonight, went up, sang it, and my husband was just stood there with his mouth wide open. He didn't know what to do, you know. Normally I'm so quiet and shy. So when I come off the stage, I'm absolutely shaking. I need somebody to calm me down quick, you know, because it's... You know, it's hard getting up there, but once I get up there, I really enjoy it. My three children are absolutely over the moon. I'm just doing it for them. Just to let them watch me on the television and be proud.
She's a mum to be proud of, Catherine Clayton. You see, it's just non-stop in your house with the kids, isn't it, really?
It is.
So, how did you feel about coming away from them? I mean, it must be terrible leaving them.
Well, it was hard. It was hard leaving them, but, you know, I think they'll understand. So.
Are they excited about this as well?
Oh, they're absolutely over the moon, yeah. They can't wait to see it on the television.
Oh, I know, they'll be thrilled with
it. Thrilled, yeah.
Look, you hardly ever get any time on your own. You never got any time on your honeymoon, did you?
No, we didn't, no.
Why, what happened?
Well, what happened was me and my husband were in a caravan site not far from where we live. And every single day, my brother cycled over on his bike just to come and see us.
Bless him. How old was he
nice,
then?
Actually. He was about 15 at the time.
What a lovely thought as well.
Lovely.
Now, you've made great strides to come here tonight. You've lost a lot of weight, haven't you?
I have, yeah.
How much have you lost?
I've lost 3 stone.
3 stone in how long?
5 months.
Now, is this true that you really are quiet and shy?
Yes, I am, yeah. Really quiet.
Because over the last 2 days you've been said, ooh, you know, I haven't got any nerves. How are you feeling now?
A nervous wreck.
They just come in the nick of time, don't they? Tell us a little bit about the person that you're going to be.
Well, she's an Australian singer, and she had quite a lot of hits in the 70s.
That'll do for us. Tell us who you're going to be, Catherine.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Helen Reddy.
Helen Reddy, the Australian songbird. From Barrow and Furness with a red-hot choice tonight, singing live, Catherine Clayton is Helen Reddy. See, you're just the kind of transformation I absolutely love, because you wouldn't think she was quiet and shy, would you? You become somebody else, and you became Helen Reddy.
Thank you.
Was it worth the effort?
Brilliant.
Brilliant, I know. Ladies and gentlemen, Catherine Clayton as Helen Reddy. Right, let's take the high road, because it's quicker than the low road, to Scotland to meet our last star guest of the series.
My name's Gary Nixon. I'm 25. I'm originally from Derry in Northern Ireland. I'm now living in Coatbridge in Scotland. I moved here because I came to Butlins last year and I fell in love with Anklet, and I've been here ever since. I'm not working at the moment, but I'm waiting employment with ScotRail on the railways, issuing tickets. I've worked on railways before, so I quite enjoy working with the public, and that's what I'd like to do. Well, I've made a lot of friends here in Coatbridge, down in the local bar, because I like them down there to do a bit of singing and enter the competitions. I had applied for Stars in the Race before. Then when I came to Scotland, Anne Collette told me that I had an excellent singing voice and that I sounded very, very like this person, and she really, really inspired me. I don't think anybody's been on Stars in the Race before from Derry, so it's a great achievement for need to come out of the town as well, and they do it for them.
And here he is, right on cue, Gary Nixon! And the good news is that you finally got that job on ScotRail, didn't you?
Certainly did, Matthew.
And tell us what you do.
Well, I issue tickets and collect penalty fares from people on the trains.
Looks like a job you could really enjoy.
Oh, it's brilliant. I love it.
do you enjoy it?
Oh, it's great. I mean, I've only been at the job 4 weeks, so I haven't really, you know, don't know yet, do you really?
Now, you went from Derry to Butlins in Scotland, where you met Anne Collett and fell in love.
Certainly did, yeah.
And so you decided to stay.
But I went home and we kept in touch,
yeah,
and we decided that we wanted to be with each other. And
you said a lovely thing about Anne Collett to me. Tell us what you said.
Well, since I've been with her, she's been a great inspiration to me. And she's carried me through this year. And without Anne Collett, I wouldn't be here tonight, without a doubt.
I think to say that anybody is a great inspiration is a fantastic thing to say. You come from a big family. You have six brothers and two sisters. And you're a musical family as well.
Yes. Well, three of my brothers have played in bands.
Yeah.
Patrick and Sean and Damien.
In fact, wasn't it Damien who introduced you to the band that you're going to be tonight?
Was Damien, yes. About 3 years ago, Damien introduced me to this song, and I fell in love with the band ever since, you know.
Yeah. And what do you like about the guy?
I just think his lyrics are brilliant, and his way of going on is brilliant, and they're the biggest band in the world.
The biggest band in the world.
They are, yes.
And he has a fabulous voice, and so do you. Tell us who you're going to be tonight, Gary.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Michael Stipe of R.E.M.
Michael Stipe, the biggest name of the 90s, with the monster sound of R.E.M. tonight, singing live, Gary Nixon is Michael Stipe.
Your day is long and the night is yours alone. When you're sure you've had enough this life, hang on. Don't let yourself go. Cause everybody cries and everybody hurts. The love you
such an emotional performance, you know. You really feel it, don't you?
Oh, aye.
I thought so, yeah. And you can see a little bit of Anne Collette's inspiration there as well. Well done, it was fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Nixon as Michael Stipe! Well, will it be Michael Stipe or another name that's chosen to go through to the live final next week? That decision is about to be made by our studio audience. Who will it be? Will it be Matt Munro, Curtis Stigers, Johnny Logan, Helen Reddy, or Michael Stipe? There they are, full of hope, but only one will get the glory. Studio audience, cast your votes now. And the winner is Michael Stipe! So, well, it was an emotional performance, and you look so cool right now. Just how cool are you feeling? You think you'll be staying with Scott Drail very long?
Hopefully. Don't let them know
us, is that? No, it's just between the 15 million of us, and it goes no further, I promise you. I never normally get people to say anything at this point. Is there anything you would like to say to Anne Collette at this particular moment?
Just that, like I said before, she's been a brilliant inspiration, and without her, I wouldn't have been here, and I wouldn't have won it, so I love you.
Thanks for sending him. Thank you, Anne Collette. Well, the stage is set for next week's big occasion. Michael Stipe has taken last place. He will be joined by Jarvis Cocker, Louis Armstrong, Susanna Hoff, John Bon Jovi, Lulu, Otis Redding, Tina Arena, Paul Carrack, Olivia Newton-John, Ronan Keating, and Brooke Benton. Something for everyone in what will be the television event of the year. And don't forget who chooses the winner. It's you. So, have the phone handy, stock up with dips and nibbles, and I'll see you there. Until then, here's Gary Nixon singing once more as Michael Stipe. Good night.
When your day is long and the night, and the night is yours alone. When you're sure you've had enough this night, hang on. Don't let yourself go. Everybody cries, and everybody hurts.